So let's look at this previous question from the topic quadratic equations and expressions. So it says, if alpha and beta are two roots of this quadratic equation, x square minus x plus 1 equal to 0, then what is alpha power 2009 and beta power 2009? Remember, more often than not, these high power questions like something raised to the power 2000 or something raised to the power like a very high value seems very difficult, but in fact it will always be a property which is coming into use because of which you will be able to do the problem. Let's see what is the property here, like how is it that I can solve a problem of this sort. It's not possible to calculate alpha and then raise it 2009 times, right? Like, you understand that it's some property that is coming into use to solve this problem. So what I'll do is I'll first find alpha, I'll first find beta, and then see how we can proceed. So alpha is nothing but 1. In fact, I will say roots. In fact, even before writing alpha, I will say roots are nothing but, which will have both of the roots in fact, minus b plus or minus under root b square, where b is minus 1. So here in your quadratic equation, a is equals to 1, b is equals to minus 1, and c is equals to 1. So minus b plus or minus under root b square, which is 1, minus 4ac, which is 4, by 2 into a, 2 into a is 2, right? So this is nothing but 1 plus or minus root 3i by 2. As you can see, that both of the roots are complex. So I will say alpha is nothing but 1 plus root 3i by 2. And I'll say beta is nothing but 1 minus root 3i by 2, right? That's why you have two roots and both of them are complex. I can write this as alpha is equals to cos pi by 6, or it'll be pi by 3 here, plus I sine pi by 3, right? I can obviously write it like this because cos pi by 3 is 1 by 2 and sine pi by 3 is root 3 by 2. And similarly, I can write beta as cos of, I can write this as minus pi by 3 plus, or you can actually do this, you can write this as cos plus pi by 3 only, minus I sine pi by 3. You can also do this, or you can take this minus sign inside. It wouldn't matter in the end, you will see. So, alpha power 2009. Now, alpha power 2009 means this quantity, power 2009. Beta power 2009 means cos pi by 3 minus I sine pi by 3 whole power 2009. Now, you guys already know, it is not possible for me to multiply this 2009 times and see what it will come. So definitely there is some property which is coming into use, and that property is coming from complex numbers, right? So it is basically De Moivre's theorem, because of which I'll bring this 2009 down and I can write it like cos of 2009 pi by 3 plus I sine 2009 pi by 3. Now remember, if I was not able to bring the power down like this, I wouldn't be able to solve this problem, right? So there has to be a property always which will help you solve problems, and the property here is this beta power 2009. Similarly, I'll bring 2009 down and I'll write like this, cos of 2009 pi by 3 minus I sine 2009 pi by 3. Now you are supposed to find the sum of these two, the sum of this and this. So when you take the sum of alpha plus, like this plus this and plus this plus this, this and this will get cancelled, right? In alpha power 2009 plus beta power 2009, all that you will get is 2 cos 2009 pi by 3, right? The sine term will get cancelled. Let's see if we can solve this. So 2009 pi by 3, what I'll do is I'll first break it into multiples of 2 pi so that those get cancelled, right? Because you guys already know cos of 2n pi plus theta is equals to cos theta. So the more 2 pi's I'm able to create, those many 2 pi's I'll be able to remove, because ultimately it'll come out to be cos theta, right? So 2009, let's see what is the nearest multiple. 2009 is not divisible by 3, obviously. But if you see 2007, that is definitely divisible by 3, because this is 3, 6, 18, 20. Once again, 3, 6, 18, 27. 3, 9, 27, right? So 669. So you can write it like this. You can write this quantity, which is alpha power 2009 plus beta power 2009 as 2 into cos of, I can write this as 669 pi plus, so 669 into 3 will give me 2007, right? But I have 2009, so I still have 2 pi by 3 left. So I'll write this as 2 pi by 3. So this is 669 into 7, and then you have a 2 pi by 3. So let's just verify 2007 plus you have a 2 pi, so you have a 2009 pi by 3. Yeah. So this you can see, this is 669 pi. So 669 is also not of the form 2n pi, because 2n pi has to be, basically you should get multiples of 2 pi, but you're not getting a multiple of 2 pi here, right? 668 would be a multiple of 2 pi, but 669 is not. So we still have to remove a pi from this. So I will say alpha power 2009 plus beta power 2009 is nothing but 2 cos, I'll remove one more pi from this, the 668 pi plus 2 pi by 3. Now the 668, now if I take this full thing as my theta here, then this is 2n pi form, right? This is the 2n pi form. So I can remove this and I can write, say, I can simply write this cos of pi plus 2 pi by 3. This is your required answer, but still you need to get the value, right? So this is nothing but 2 cos of, so cos of pi plus theta is nothing but minus cos theta, right? So I can write this as, minus of 2 cos 2 pi by 3, if I take my 2 pi by 3 as theta. But cos 2 pi by 3 is nothing but minus half, because it's nothing but cos of pi minus pi by 3. It's in the second quadrant and cos pi by 3 is half. So you have a minus half here also. That minus and this minus will multiply, and I'll say minus 2 into minus half. Ultimately what you get is 1. The correct answer to this question is